The American Psychological Association defined loneliness as an emotional and cognitive discomfort. You know, it's something more. Personally, I'm a tough person, and I'm a bit, as he explained, as a nerd. And the definition for me of loneliness was kind of weakness that we need to tackle down. And that's why, unfortunately, I was telling to my young kid, like, move, like, find new friends, do something, don't be lazy. And it's wrong, because if you talk to someone who is suffering from rejection, you are doing it really bad. But the revelation came later from my ex-wife, Valerie, who was so lonely. Even if she was like a really a nice person, she was enjoyable, but she was away from her country. And change begins during the COVID-19. Everybody was touched by loneliness. And she started to ask me a question like, Jean-Claude, would you think that AI, a day, will understand who we really are? Like, not on the surface, not likes and dislikes, and eventually can bring to us some people who can be a friend. It's so difficult. It can be a game changer. And you know, it was turning in my head, and I was saying, huh, okay, so she wants to use technology to free ourselves from technology. Interesting. And then she added something else. It's like a quote from Michel Kwan. If you have nothing in life but one good friend, you're rich. And then again, I will say, like, huh, if we can duplicate that, you know, to the global world, could be something very interesting. But stop. I want first to confront you about loneliness. You know that there is one person in three in this world who is suffering from loneliness? And in Switzerland, I'm sorry to say, but it's 52% of the population. So there is no way in this room there is even one person who is not touched by loneliness, directly or, like me, indirectly. Now, try to figure. It's the same numbers than the cancer. 6 billion people die every year because of loneliness. In the United States, in terms of economy, we talk about more than $200 billion losses last year. And if we talk about countries, the UK and Japan appointed Minister of Loneliness. And I can go like with more facts, but I want to stop on one which is terrible and intriguing. The latest researches demonstrate that if you have a lack of connections for a long period, which happened during the COVID to many people, part of your brain disappears. I'm talking about the hippocampus in your brain where you have the oxytocin sensor. That's the center of empathy. So it degenerates. And imagine that with millions of people, it's a physical handicap. It's just like if you are socially blind. So when you understand all of that, you can, I think, understand that loneliness is not just a discomfort. It's a huge global societal crisis. Now, step back and try to figure on a global and societal point of view. If you have less empathy, you have less belonging. If you have less belonging, then you have more exclusion, more angers. That's the breeding rock for riots and war. Try to think about it. So today I want to give you a message of hope, okay? There are solutions, and we are working on one that would be accessible to all. What we believe is that where you socialize, you civilize. Now, how it's working with the AI. So many people have fear about the AI, so let me translate that. AI is under control. We are developing the algorithm. AI can do a lot better than humans in terms of processing the data. The problem is, what is in the core of the AI? What are the rules? What are the ethical rules? And I personally believe that as long as it's good, there is no risk. But we have major companies around the world, the big tech, you know, the one who promises togetherness and happiness. That's a wonderful promise. I have the feeling that they are more about profit than well-being. I let you judge. So this company have put inside the AI, at the core, some processes that tell that we want to enslave people in front of their screen. I believe that's where we open the Pandora box. And of course, I do not recommend to do that, and we are on a different approach. Our approach is quite simple. What we want is AI to be personalized and to talk with its real owner, you, the user, to just simply talk about life, talk about everything, to get pure data. Because the problem of this big tech company is that they only have access to your virtual persona, a digital kind of mask. And we agree that most of the people don't talk on the internet like the really way they are really. So, how it will work? What we understood in the inspiration of Dr. Cassiopo, a neuropsychologist, is that we need to fight against a vicious cycle, which is a loneliness cycle. It starts where? It starts from a fear of rejection. This is a survival instinct. So that fear, in it, a biases in our way we connect. Then we are over-vigilant, then we are overreacting, then the people in front of us are just like, wow, this person is weird. I want to connect with that person. And what happened is a rejection. And again in that cycle, to the point where we prefer to stay home in front of a screen. And you remember what happened to the brain. So what we found is that we need to tackle directly at the origin of the problem, before people meet. How? Imagine an AI you can talk with, and that AI can organize for you some social events where you will meet people. The AI will just tell you, like, okay, no worries. The people you will meet are not hostile. These people will appreciate you the way you are. They are compatible. They are even interested to meet you. And then no reasons to have fear. And that's really how it must work. It will reduce the level of cortisol, and it will make people, again, a possibility to connect. So, you understand that we need now to bridge from virtual to real. I want to be clear. The AI is not about making kind of virtual things. So it will organize created automated events where you will have that possibility to meet people, I will not say similar to you, because we want to promote diversity, but people who will be enthusiastic about meeting you. Now, try to play a game. Imagine that you are a wedding planner. Tough tack. So what you have to do is to deal with many different kind of people and to put them around tables. Then why not to think like, okay, opposite attract, good. Okay, but similarity is mine. Wow, human is complex. No worries, AI is capable to understand that kind of complexity because it masters at resolving complex problem. Now, you can imagine that at a global scale, because that's what we want to achieve. And you understand that we want that on spot, like no time to prepare, you know, the wedding months and months in advance. And you will think like, okay, is that guy is crazy or is it really possible? Because it sounds like Amazon logistics, but way more complicated because we talk about human interaction. So what I can tell you is that, yes, it is definitely possible with only, when I say only, is money, AI cost a lot, time. We will bring that product that will impact the world. But I don't want to be long. I just want to tell you one thing, is that we need that AI to be available. What about your own impact? Around you, you have many people, maybe your kids, like mine, maybe some colleague, most probably, not sure, grandparents, who feel lonely. And what AI can do at a global scale, you can do at your own scale. So we are not talking about replacing friends. It's not what we are doing. What we propose to you today is just to open your heart, to open your eyes, and to accept people around you the way they are. If you do that, it will be magical. So, loneliness is terrible, we agree. But benevolence and belongingness is more powerful. Merci.